Hello, everybody, and welcome to another episode of Jack Wall's career in Rise of Flight. We're going to continue with my character Jacques Duval, flying with Ordante 12, I believe. I was wounded in action, and I was taken to hospital in the last episode because I can't land the plane. But we had some reinforcements anyway, which probably helps protect my plane. And there's a picture that I didn't expect to see. Anyway, we are 3 sorties in for a total of 3 successful sorties, with a score of 3, which is awesome. Let's move on to the next mission and see how we're going. I guess I'm going to recuperate quickly, I hope. E Castaril 12, not it, don't they? E Castaril. E Castarille 12. No information there. Next day, we are now in bad weather. Poor conditions to fly and schedule sorties for the next day. All missions have been scrubbed. So, where are we now? We're Tuesday the 12th of September 1916, and looks like it's a nice day based on this. It's a new day. Some heavy clouds at 1400 meters, but let's see what's going on. I have another prediction to do, which is most likely... No. Oh, I have a balloon attack that's scheduled, which is a bit of a change. Normally it's a patrol, but at 16:10 I have a balloon attack with Romain and Dominique. So that'll be a little exciting. So we'll click through these. The morning flight is a line patrol, so nothing too crazy there. That was completed. The early afternoon is a protection patrol, which I've done 2 times now, and crash-landed twice. That's been completed. So here we go, getting ready to make an attack on a balloon. So it's easing me in gently here. Not going up against German aircraft straight away, which is good, I suppose, in the scheme of things. He says. Still haven't learned any of the aircraft. We're taking off here. We're flying through Betran. We are turning on the fork here of that towards Saint-Michel. And then we return back, and I am wingman number 1 here, so if I manage to get up, I'll be lining up on the right. Okay. Now the question is, if I can remember how to start one of these things. Come on. Come on. I'm going to be left behind as usual. Because I can't start it. No. Bloody hell. I can never remember what the settings need to be for my starting position. That might be better. No. Lord above, I do have rudder control at least. Oh. That's good. We got started. More by accident. Let's get a little bit of up and go then. There we go. Back on our alrighty. Charge the weapon. Anybody see anybody around here recently? Might have to look at the map on this one. We're going out between these two here. There's the river. So we're heading back this direction. I think we're going up here. There's the base. The river is behind me. So, and there's a road there, I think. Is that the base? There's a little triangle there. No. The river there, it should be up here. Yeah, that didn't cut the knob there. Then there's a bigger set of forestry which stretches out to there. Yeah. Basically, we're going to head away from the river in this direction. I don't actually have a compass here anywhere in the cockpit, which is a bit of a pain. Now, is there a town up there? There is. I think that is Vavincourt. That makes sense, and there's a railway that's cutting down through the forestry here. You can just see it there, so this is the right direction. We're just behind, we're behind our flight. And we're heading in this direction basically until we meet the second sub-fork of the second fork, and we should see the town of Villotti just to our south on the railway. So essentially I just need to follow the railway. That'll do it. Stupid starting machine thing. That was just a test fire. That I can at least have that ready to go. That's the railway, you see, cutting through the forestry there a bit only. Let's see if we can get a little bit more speed going on. What I'm doing is I'm looking at the rev counter and I am adjusting my mixture until I see the needle drop, and then I'm pushing it back. And that is the maximum that I'm going to be able to get out of the aircraft, I reckon, at this point in time. So we need to do a little bit of navigation using using the railway and using the rivers. And the first thing that I notice on the railway is that by Betrain, there's a T-junction on the railway that heads up on the near side of the first fork. And that's not too far away from a curve which cuts through the forestry, so I don't think we're too far away from Betrain at the moment. I think it's just under our nose, because the railway cuts through that piece of forestry just on the right there, and that is Betrain. I'm murdering the pronunciation, I know. Let's just zoom in on it here. Or maybe it's Belrain. Anyway, who knows? Just go in a little bit more to there. That's good. That will mean that we can actually follow our track. So that's Belrain there. Just got a little off course. Should have some friendlies somewhere up here. God knows where they are. We'll try and catch up with them. And then there's a river there, and that river has two forks. We want to get to the second fork, and then it forks again, and we want to get to the second one of those before we take a slight deviation, basically more of an easterly direction towards Saint Michel, which is interesting river formations that it just stops there. One assumes it goes underground or something. We've also got cloud here, and I don't like flying through cloud. So we're going to fly around it. And we're even going to try and land. There's the railway, just under the wing there. Disappeared now by the cloud, but we're even going to try and land this time without crashing, because the old nurses were very nice in the hospital, and so it was good to go there, but the food was shocking. And yeah, no need to go back there again. Wondering where my friends are. I'm possibly after overshooting them. I don't see them at all. Just trying to check the ground. You see, there's the two sub-forks, and we're going to turn now onto the fork. So my friends are going to be in the direction I'm looking at now somewhere. There's Velotti. That's the town of Velotti, just off to the right there. And judging by the forestry, we are going to be passing just along this edge of the forestry here. And heading straight for Saint-Michel, which is... is it Michel or Mithiel? Oh Christ, my pronunciations are kind of brutal. Mihail. Saint Mihail. Well, that's good enough. Apparently I should have some friendlies up in front of me here. But I'll be damned. Maybe they're coming in low. I should be faster than them though, because I'm a little higher. I should be faster at starting my aircraft, I suppose, and then I wouldn't lose them. But anyway, we'll catch them. Or we'll go and take down the balloon on our own. I'm not seeing any friendlies. I'm not seeing anything. Quite a nice day for flying, though. do need to do those edits to my track IOR a little bit more. I tried... Whoa, come back down. I tried a little bit, but I didn't really do enough, I think. Now, passing back over the railway, which is what we've just done. Although that railway does curve around, and that's not showing up on the map. Which is interesting. Why would it not be showing up on the map? Maybe that railway is not showing up on the map because it's not on the map. Maybe because I'm not going the right direction. Let's see, we've got clouds here now as well, but I should be in significant forestry without any breaks, judging by the map. And I think I am just a little south of where I need to be. No, I'm not. I'm way south on where I need to be. I've just worked it out. There's a... Yeah. There's... That there is... Wait a minute. Just doing a bit of a turn here just to have a look-see. I am of the opinion that I need to be traveling up here. You see that distinctive cut into the forestry there? I think that corresponds with that. And just underneath the cloud, there is a town. And there shouldn't be. So... That actually is accurate. So that town, do I see a town there? Well, it's not really a very big town, it's just a little village, so that's okay. There's the front line. And there's the dip in, so this is right, this is right. This is a superior route to take. Yeah, there's the little cut in. That cut in corresponds with the, yeah. If you see what I'm looking at here, there's the cut-in of the forestry just below my wing, and then there's a cut-in just by the struts, and that corresponds with my route, so I'm actually on the return side of that cut right now, and I hear aircraft. I didn't see him, but I did hear him. There's two of them. What are they doing down there? They're going that way. No, they're going in my direction as well. They're just spread out a little. Well, I think I'm on the right direction, so I'm going to keep going this way. And see if these guys choose to... Yeah, you see they're dropping down there as well. This, I suppose, is just a pretty good guidance. I mean, those entry and exit routes are pretty much the same. San Michel is just off the loop of the river, which is just in front of us, basically. And, the two boys are with us as well, we're just separated by a little bit. This is good. Now, apparently there's a balloon in here. There's the other loop, so San Michel should be on my blipper here. I keep calling it San Michel, San Mikhail. Unfortunate to be living in this town cut from the First World War, wouldn't it? Well, I suppose you wouldn't be living in the town. That's Fleck going on. There's my friend. And I think there's the balloon, is it? There's a balloon over there. And there seems to be a general plan to head for it. And that would be the general location of where it should be. And he's gone in first. He's coming in higher. So I should, well, I'm number two, so I'm just going to maneuver in over in between and take my turn. Black is pretty active. Gone high. Is he coming back? I'm not sure what he's doing. He's playing high cover whilst I go in for the shot, I suppose. No, he's turning away now. I think they're pulling that balloon down quite quickly. Oh, there's another balloon there. Might have got hit by a fleck or something. Well, there's another balloon. There's one in front of me. Let's go for the one in front of me. Kind of pulling these balloons down, it seems. I think I'm injured again. I also think that that balloon is not really destroyed enough. Question will be, can we give it one more shoot? Thank you. Wait a minute, that wasn't friendly. Get out of here, I think. Two against one is not good odds. Still getting flack at me. I haven't been talking all that much because I've been concentrating quite a bit. We've got that balloon down. I've taken a couple of hits. I think I'm knocked my head or something because I'm slightly injured and I have an enemy coming in on my six, so I need to start getting out of his firing line a little bit. The plane is intact. Good, but I also think I have another balloon placement over here, and I don't really want to mess with that too much. Aggressive would be to take on this pilot. I don't seem to be able to fly this thing well enough, but I'm out of ammo. No, I'm not. Bloody hell. I didn't rearm the gun. Had a great shot. The hell is shooting me now? Well, the mission was to take down a balloon. And I've done that. He's after me though, and I'm not going to be able to get away from his airspace. Okay, time to get out of here, I think, because he's just bringing me over the field, which is getting me shot to shit. There's no guarantee I'm going to make it back. We've got our mission achieved. And, I'm not even sure he's following me. A bit low though. Our return route is basically straight back across here. We need to climb out so we don't get hot-shotted by the ground forces here. There's flak coming my way, which is hardly a surprise. But so far so good. Taking a few shots, you can see a few holes in the back of me, but I'm not too bad. Climb out. Just need to get my landmarks right now, so I need to basically stay on the other side of this. That's that loop that comes in there, and then it doubles and comes out, which is there. Well, that's going to be down there then. That's the town. We're coming out on this side of it, which is our right. And then it's just basically fly back to the railway and look out for that fork. Okay. At least get back to our own side of the line, I suppose, would be the plan. And altitude is health. I believe that's my first kill. At least it's my first balloon down. So it's my first... Well, we'll find out if it's confirmed. There's nobody around here to confirm me. My wingmen have disappeared and left me alone, which is a bit bad, really. Actually, they're not my wingmen. One is my wing leader. I should have been following him. I wonder how that works out. That's that section there, so we are... Yeah. We're a little low, but we're good. That's that long run that comes in there, so if we were to fly out... Actually, our line is pretty good here. So we're running commentary when I'm flying. May happen in the future. But it's unlikely to be too much talking at the moment, because I'm biting my lip and trying to keep the pipper on the mark. But it'll come with time, I suppose. I'm nearly as bad in IL-2. So... there's that cut there, and there's that cut there. So we should be on a fairly decent flight path towards Villach. It should be just in front of us. We pass south of Villach and basically pick up the railway at Belrain. I say that like I'm a local. There's the cut in that. I've definitely got a bit of a dimmer screen, or a slightly rosy screen, and there were a few blood splats that came up. So, I think I've got hit by flak, just in a minor way. But nevertheless... it's not good, but the focus now is going to be on completing the return trip and landing this aircraft for a change. Shall we be able to land? Should we do it? Will we be able to do it? If past performance is any indicator of future performance, then the answer is no. We have to buck that trend, at least. I hear aircraft, or do I just think I hear aircraft? Or is my own aircraft dying on me? No. There's a bit of patching up to do, and it does feel a little bit like the stability is somewhat affected. Mind you, these things are about as stable as a baby's bum anyway. Okay. There's a railroad somewhere out to our right that we haven't come across yet. I fear I'm a little bit too much south now. Yeah, I'm way too south again. Should be up here a little bit. There's that cut, and I should be passing just underneath it, so... get a little further up here, and then I'll... should be looking for the town of... Villach. Just off the railway. Now, the railway travels well north of that, so the railway is up there a little bit, so I should intersect the railway... somewhere here. Oh, that's Villach up there. Oh god, yeah, I was really travelling in the wrong direction. I'm looking at the shape of the forestry. And this little knob that I have, this where the pipper is pointing now, Velot is just there. And the railway is there as well, so I need to basically begin my left bank. We should have... What should we have? We should have another railway south of the first fork now. I don't see the railway yet. But I am... That is Villot there, just underneath, in between the wings. I think I see the... no, I don't. Is my vision... Is that the yeah, that's the railway. I thought I saw that. So that's good. Basically, we need to follow that. Let the railway drift over onto our left. For its loop. We're basically going to cross this railway now and then let the railway... we're going to follow the railway. Let's make it simple, stupid. There's the railway doing its little kink. We're traveling quite quickly, so... right in front of us, he says. Yeah. Translating from the map onto the thing is... I'm getting used to it, but... Actually, our turning point is just in front of us here now. Staying out of the... let's stay out of those clouds. That's another town. And there's the river. So there should be a railway going through that town, and I think there is. Yes, there is. So right in front of the nose, the two railways should meet. I'm just going to come over the town a little bit so I can see if these two railways meet, and they do. They meet right there. Whoa. That's where they meet. Now, judging on our map, from there, we're heading back, basically keeping the railway on our right, on our left even. So let me slip it over here a little bit. And now we're just going to follow the railway through the trees. We'll get down a little lower here because we safely can. And just before we hit the water of the river, we should have our base. So. Right, preparation in my head now for landing. Basically, I need to slow down a hell of a lot more than I have been slowing down. And once I land, I need to keep my stick back to do everything in my power to keep it on the ground. I think I can see the base. The base is right on my pipper now, just there. So we will reduce altitude as we go in and begin that now. If we just get past this forestry. We are descending at the same time, so we're maintaining quite a bit of speed. I have no idea what our speed is. 120, 130 miles an hour, maybe. That just would be too much more than that. And then we're just going to keep the flying alive. I think that is our base. Base on the other side of those trees. Okay. It's a different base though. We're not where we were before. So, how am I going to remember this? Well, it's grid 24, I suppose, at the start. There's a couple of little pockets of trees and it's just before the river, and the river has kind of a weird two lakes to it. And it's in between a long run, so I should be able to remember that formation. I quite like the fact that there's a lot of forestry and trees, because it means I can make visual markers quite quickly. And I'm pretty good at that. I don't see anybody else in the air. Then I didn't see them over when I was dogfighting a little bit. Call that dogfighting. When I was flying around with that enemy aircraft, I didn't see any of my friendlies either, so they don't appear to have landed yet. And I am number two, so right, how do we do this landing? I think we just try to bring it in for that border there. So we go out a ways here. Mind you, I didn't get a let's just go back up a little bit. Normally you get a flare, don't you? Certainly no flare showing. What was the plan? The plan was to fly over there and then fly back. Which I did. And we took down one, what you call it, balloon, and I've flown back. How much fuel do I have? I don't know if I have enough. I'm just going to bring it into land and we'll have to make a decision on what we do from there. I don't see anything in the distance. And I don't see any planes having landed. Okay, focus on landing, let's bring it in and let's see what the end result is. Definitely no aircraft landed down there. Or is there? Is that an aircraft? No, that's a car. Monsieur General has arrived. Well, maybe the aircraft are put back into their hangar already. That's a possibility. What's that interesting river design which has just stopped there underground again, I suppose. You get a lot of that in France. Well, I think that's enough for the final. That is what I call a landing with part of a wing. Okay, actually she stops fairly quickly when she hits. I just landed very late. I didn't land by the mark at all, which is what I wanted to do. But once she does tip down, she's pretty much going to stop pretty quickly. I'm going to go up by the hangar up here. That'll do. Engine off. So, I've lost a bit of a wing, got a couple of holes in it. Couple of holes in the fuselage at the back. Otherwise we're down. So let's see if we're back too early. Let's finish the flight. Are you sure? Yes, I am. And now we're loading up our results, and the result is that I'm injured again, but this time I landed the plane. I'm credited with one balloon destroyed. And it looks like the other two are still in the air. So I came back, I lost them and I came back too soon. Okay. Back to the hospital for me, I suppose. Bad food, but nice nurses. But it's bad food. Wounded in action. I've been given an award. I've got the Croix de Guerre. I've got the War Cross. But I'm also in hospital. Maybe the nurses will think better of me. Wounded in action. Jesus. That's twice now. Once was my own fault. But this time it wasn't. Okay, well, there we go. I made a successful landing. I got a balloon and didn't quite follow my leader, which is not so good, but we'll correct that going forward. So until next time, fly safe.